Hi, my name is Lindsay. My story starts about my sophomore year of high school. I started getting really bad anxiety attacks that came about once a month, and then once a week, and then several times a week, to eventually every day. And they got progressively worse over time. I would hyperventilate to the point of passing out on several occasions, and with it came depression and bipolar disorder, which runs pretty heavily in my family. And when I was in high school, I kind of dismissed it to being too stressed out. I had a lot on my plate. I was in extracurriculars. I was taking a lot of advanced courses. I was working a job. So I kind of just let it go. And I had a terrible diet. I had the classic American diet, tons of sugar, you know, tons of milk and cheese and pasta, and just not really caring about my health at all. And when I graduated and moved out with my boyfriend, it got significantly worse. I was drinking and smoking, which obviously wasn't helping, and the depression overwhelmed me to a point that I felt like I really couldn't function. I couldn't even work. So I went to see the doctor, and I was stuck with a nurse practitioner for 5 minutes before I was prescribed for Lexapro. And I went and picked up the prescription, and I started taking it, and immediately I noticed that it just knocked me out. It turned me into a zombie. You know, I was staring off into space and staring at walls all the time, just no emotions. It quelled the anxiety, but it took everything else out of me too. I mean, I was just a robot, not even functioning as a human anymore. And I was also seeing a psychologist at the same time. And he told me basically that I needed to think happier thoughts and use more positive words and basically just fake it till you make it, which was infuriating because you can't help feeling like that. There was nothing I could. It's not that I was thinking negatively because I'm a negative person. I couldn't help how I was feeling, and I was frustrating, always battling myself, trying to think more positive thoughts, thinking that that was just going to fix everything. So I stopped seeing him, and after about 6 months of taking Lexapro, I decided to wean myself off because I didn't like who it was turning me into. I wasn't myself anymore. I couldn't do the things that I love. I wanted to be a painter, and I couldn't bring myself to do. I would just bawl my eyes out in front of a canvas. And I just wasn't myself, so I stopped taking it, and I just kind of struggled through the depression and the anxiety attacks, and eventually developed stomach ulcers, was constantly having digestion issues, and headaches, and body aches, and just lived with it for 2 years, not really knowing what I could do with it, in and out of doctor's offices all the time, trying to fix the stomach problems. And eventually I heard Kelly Brogan come on the Joe Rogan podcast, and initially I dismissed it, not because I didn't think that she had a convincing argument, but because I didn't think that I could do the 30 days. I didn't have enough faith in myself. I didn't think that I would have the willpower to do something like that. And the idea of failure just wasn't an option for me. And a couple months later, you know, I'd been in several really harsh arguments with my boyfriend, and I'd pushed myself away from my family and friends. And I'd come to a point that I realized that it wasn't just my life anymore. It was everybody else that I care about. I was affecting them, and I was bringing everybody else down with me. And I decided I needed to not be selfish. I needed to do absolutely everything I could to get over this for my life and for everybody else's. And so I bought the book, and I read it cover to cover, and I re-listened to the podcast 2 more times, and I just integrated every single little detail that I could pick up into my life. And I was strict. I did not cheat once for 30 days. And the first 2 weeks were a little roller coaster for me. But after that, the second 2 weeks of the program were effortless. You know, my energy levels had skyrocketed. I had so much energy. My mood had stabilized. It wasn't so much that I was just happy all the time. I mean, I was genuinely happy for what felt like the first time in my life, but I just felt like I could deal with the problems that I had in my life. I could deal with challenges and struggles. I could see my life genuinely and honestly for the first time. It didn't feel like I was looking through any sort of filter and lens. It didn't feel like my emotions were controlling me. I felt like I could legitimately make confident decisions in my life. And it's given me the motivation and confidence to pursue my career as an artist. And it's given me my life back. Or not even my life back. It's given me a new life to start out with. And being so young, I'm only 21 years old. It's inspiring to see what I'm going to be able to do for the next 40, 50, 60 years of my life. And I'm so genuinely grateful for what I've been given. And I guess all I can say is thank you to Kelly, because she's changing lives.